Welcome back to my channel. Today I filmed this Valentine's Day romantic kind of look. It's quite bold, but I feel like it's wearable as well. I'm calling this a Valentine's Day makeup tutorial because I'm hoping to have it up by Valentine's Day, but if I don't, you guys obviously don't need to be told that you can wear this look wherever you like. I think it'll be perfect for date night. It's got those really nice pinky, purpley, romantic tones. And then I did a vampy lip with this look because I've been doing a lot of nude lips lately, but you could obviously wear this with a nude lip. I think like a pinky nude would look so beautiful with this makeup. So obviously you do whatever you're comfortable in. Do you guys have any plans for Valentine's Day? Me and my boyfriend never really do Valentine's Day. We don't really celebrate it that much. But yeah, let me know if you've got any cute plans, or even if you're just, you know, hanging out with your friends, or if you plan on eating a whole pizza by yourself and watching a movie. You know, all of that sounds really freaking good to me. A little quick life update. I haven't uploaded for a few weeks now, and that kind of breaks my heart. And I'm really sorry about that because I do try to get a video up every week. So if you watched my Get to Know Me video that I did a couple of months ago, I said that I had just finished university. And the reason that I haven't been uploading frequently is because I have got a job, a full-time job now. So I don't really have a lot of time to film like I used to. I used to be able to film like pretty much most days of the week, and now the only time I have to film is basically on the weekend. And the last two weekends have been crazy. It was my birthday, my boyfriend had his awards ceremony for his work, and we've been away both weekends, and then life has just been crazy in the meantime. So it's Saturday night, the time is 12:05 a.m. It's been a tough night, and if I'm stumbling over my words or I seem tired or I seem out of it, it's probably because I is. If you can hear a noise in the background, it's because I've got a fan going. We are literally going through a heat wave here in Australia. It was almost 45 degrees here today, so, so hot. So I couldn't really film in the day. We don't have air conditioning here, so it would have been a sweaty mess of a video. So that's why I'm filming at night. That's why I've got a fan going. So there's gonna be a slight little noise in the background, but I'm hoping my mic is mainly getting my voice. So sorry about that if it bugs you, but it was that or melting makeup off my face. So I really hope you guys are well. I am really, really, really loving my job. I am, you know, I never thought I'd be so happy working full time, but I really am. The only downfall is that I really don't get time to film these videos for you guys as often, but I am gonna do my best. There's no way I'm giving up on my channel. It is my passion and my dream and my love, and I'm definitely gonna be making time for that as often as possible. So definitely leave your video recommendations down below. Let me know what you'd like to see next. I really hope you guys enjoy this tutorial and it gives you some inspo for the next glam event you've got going on. And I think I've rambled for like a good like 5 minutes now, so I'm gonna shut up and get into the tutorial. So I am gonna start with my brows done today. If you can see a little bit of foundation around them, I've kind of like tried to clean them up a little bit. I put Eden Primer Potion on from MDK, obviously, and I'm just going to blend that in. Tarte Shape Tape in Light Sand, and I'm just gonna put that under the brows a little bit. I'm just gonna take the RCMA No Color Powder and set my lids. This is the Huda Beauty Rose Gold Palette. I finally got my hands on this and I freaking love it. I am taking the shade Bay to start off with, and I'm just using this as my transition. So I'm gonna kind of drag my shadow out a bit, and also I want it in this inner part of the crease too. I have seriously missed filming. Like I felt so like guilty that I haven't had any time. Like literally on the weekends, so 2 weekends ago, it was my birthday. I turned 22, and my boyfriend, he took me away for the night and we stayed somewhere and he threw a surprise dinner for me at one of my favorite restaurants. So that was lovely. And then last weekend he had an award ceremony because he was nominated for an award and he won. So that was amazing. And again, that was another night away in the city. I'm gonna take Flamingo now, which is this one. This is the Smith 247. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I gotta say, I've been using this palette a little bit. Like, I haven't been able to do like full glam looks because I kind of just wear like quite a natural look to work. But I have been playing with this palette a little bit when I can. And can I just say, I am so impressed and I'm so in love with the color selection. Like, I literally think this palette has everything you need in it. Okay, now I'm gonna take Maneater, which is this red shade, and I'm gonna blend this up in the crease. And I also want to get that on the outer part of the lid there. Now I'm going to use the Smith 235 brush. It's got like a point on the end, and I'm going to take Bossy, which is this kind of like plummy brown shade, and I'm going to add that more directly into the crease to create like depth and all that shiz. I'm going to go in with Coco as well, which is that shade. Sorry, it's really hard for me to show you. And I'm just going to add this right in the outer, just like really low. I don't want to bring this color up too high. Okay, I'm going to spray this brush. This is the Smith 253 brush. I'm just going to spray with some Fix Plus. Just a little bit. And I'm going to take Angelic, which is one of my personal fave colors in the palette. Just going to use that damp. Like, can we, do you see that? So pretty. Because I'm using it wet and it's quite opaque, I'm sort of just carving out that front half of my lid there. I'm gonna take Black Truffle, which is just the matte black from the palette, and I'm gonna do my liner with this. I want to make it a little darker in that outer corner, so I'm gonna mix the Bossy shade with the black and kind of just add that a little bit to the outer V. I just want it to be really deep. Now I'm gonna go and add lashes. Today I'm using Bespoke Lashes in the style Aisha. These are seriously beautiful. Like, they are silk, I believe, and they just go on so easily. The band is such a nice thickness where it molds really well to your eye, but it's not too thick where it feels really uncomfortable and you just want to rip them off. Okay, so I'm going to move on to the face now, and I'm going to use a little bit of my Makeup Forever hydrating primer. I wasn't even going to use this, but since I took my makeup off before, my skin is feeling really stripped. Oh, and I have like none left. And I'm also going to use a little bit of my Hourglass Veil primer. This has been like my obsession lately. When I want my makeup to last ages, I love using the Hourglass primer. For foundation today, I'm gonna use the Tarte Rainforest of the Sea foundation. This is in the shade Light Sand. And I'm just gonna, I think I use about 2 pumps. I honestly wish this was just in a normal pump bottle. That's the only, like literally the only negative thing I can say about this. And I'm just gonna blend it out with my beauty blender. Okay, now I'm going to conceal, and I'm going to use the Tarte Shape Tape. I've already opened this one. This is also an obsession of mine, and I'm going to use the shade Light Neutral and Light Sand. Now this I use quite sparingly because it is high coverage and I don't want to look too like cakey under the eyes. So I'm just doing a couple of dots of each color. I'm gonna go ahead and set my under eyes with the RCMA powder. The stuff is amazing. Kind of like flies everywhere though. You can probably see it in the air, like what? To further set my face and also add a little bit more coverage, I'm gonna use my NARS Orly Luminous Pressed Powder Foundation in Fiji. Looks like this. Just kind of stamp that in. I find this just gives a really flawless look to the face. I'm just gonna highlight my inner corner with Starry Eyed from Makeup Geek. This is a foiled shadow, so it's gonna give that really nice high shine on that inner corner there. Oh, I love the Makeup Geek foiled shadows. On the waterline, I'm gonna use the NARS. Look how like grubby this is. It like, I think it like melted a little bit, but anyway, this is the NARS waterproof. It's the nude eyeliner. That was a little bit of a fail, so I'm actually switching to Highbrow from Benefit. That's what I mean. Now I'm gonna take Shy and Man Eater Mixed, which are these two, and I'm just gonna blend this slightly under the eye. I'm gonna take a little Smith 212. I was in the 212. You guys know that song? I love that song. And I'm gonna mix Bossy and Cocoa, just cause why not? I'm just pressing this like right underneath the lash line. This is really gonna make that liner pop as well. I'm gonna use Medium Tan from MAC. This is a mineralized skin finish, and I'm just gonna use a big bronzer brush. This is actually technically the Real Techniques blush brush, but I'm just gonna use this to add warmth to the face. Just using a bit of the Too Faced Milk Chocolate Bronzer to contour. Oh, and I love this brush for contouring. This is the Smith 112. Shoot, it's good. It's gonna contour my nose a little bit as well. Using MAC Warm Soul Blush on the cheeks. I am so devastated. One of you guys let me know that the old Warm Soul that I have is not the same as the new one in the new packaging. So now I'm like savoring this and I'm like, oh, I wish I'd bought like 5 of them. For my highlight, I'm gonna take Opal from Becca. I'm gonna layer this with another highlight as well. I'm gonna use a bit of Mary Luminizer over the top. Just gonna go and clean up a bit under there. Doing that makes such a difference. I'm just using my the NARS powder I used to set my face to do that. For lips, I'm gonna use MAC Current Lip Pencil, and I'm gonna line my lips and fill them in with this too. So as you can see, that is not perfect at all, but that's fine because I really only wanted the lip liner to map out a bit of a shape and give me a base for what we're about to put down, and that is the Colored Rain liquid lipstick in the shade Mary. This is a beautiful metallic, but it's not too metallic. It just gives a little bit of a sheen. And to finish the look off, I'm going to use my Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray. Probably don't even need to tell you guys that anymore. Do you guys know if Urban Decay reformulated this? Like, I know they've got the new packaging, but mine is in the old packaging clearly, and it smells really weird. Like, I've never noticed a smell. So do you guys think it's off, or have you guys bought this recently and have you noticed like a weird smell? Let me know, because I'm actually really concerned that this is like off. Even though I like just bought it, when I spray it, I notice the worst smell. It's like, oh. Okay guys, so that completes the look. I really hope you guys enjoyed this. Yeah, I'll see you guys soon. I am gonna be filming more videos for you guys when I can. So leave your video recommendations down below, and also let me know what you thought of this look. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. Mwah.